Nigeria conducts general elections every 4 years to determine those to take over the realm of affairs at various levels of government. Unfortunately, the electorate have always displayed a lack of enthusiasm every election year due to the fact that such polls are always marred by gross irregularities as well as lack of credibility. It is against this backdrop of that and other flaws that relevant political stakeholders have over the years clamored for more adoption of modern techniques, especially the electronic voting system, to improve the nation's electoral process. Section 52, subsection 1B of the Electoral Act 2010, as amended, outlaws electronic voting in Nigeria, as it states, the use of electronic voting machine for the time being is prohibited. However, the Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, seemed to be disposed to adopting such voting method if the extant laws are put in place. INEC Chairman Professor Mahmood Yakubu, who hinted on the plan last week in a policy document on the forthcoming governorship elections in Edo and Ondo states, said the Electoral Commission will work towards the full introduction of electronic voting in major elections starting from 2021. Joining us now is Festus Okoye, INEC National Commissioner for Information and Voter Education. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you so much.
Is electronic voting the masterstroke we have been looking for, in that it means we finally have a chance to vote right people into power?
Well, I believe that electronic voting or internet voting is the way to go. Over the years, Nigerians have been clamoring for the introduction of more technology into our electoral process. But whether we adopt electronic voting systems, or whether we adopt internet voting, or whether we adopt the paper, manual paper voting that we've had all over the years, what is key, what is important, what is fundamental is the trust the people have in the democratic process and in the electoral process. Anytime there's trust deficit in the electoral process, no matter the system you adopt, people will want to corrupt it. But I believe that the deeper use of technology will, to a greater extent, eliminate human errors and human interference in the electoral process. So the electoral management body is disposed towards moving to the electronic voting systems, taking into consideration our demography, our culture, our values, our history, and where we are coming from. And so we are working towards the adoption of electronic voting systems in our electoral process.
We understand that you're set to run a pilot. When are you thinking of doing this, and how will it work?
You know, the commission has been running pilots in relation to various systems for quite a while now. Over a period of time, we've been running pilots on electronic collation and electronic transmission of results. So what we intend to do is that beginning from 2021, we are going to make sure that one, that we acquire the appropriate technology that suits our demography, that suits our geography, that suits our culture, and also suits the level of infrastructure we have in the country. And then we are going to use some of the smaller by-elections, maybe a state constituency election, a House of Representative election, or even a senatorial by-election to test run how it will work before we fully deploy it to a bigger election.
The 17-page document that was released as, guidelines for conducting elections during this pandemic, what aspects of it do you think deserves greater scrutiny?
Well, I believe that the electoral management body has been thinking ahead, and that was why we decided to produce this particular document as a policy document, as a guide to all the critical stakeholders in the electoral process. So we are going to make sure that we respect the people's right to vote and at the same time protect the people's right to health and safety. But what is critical and what is important is the behavior of the political parties at the polling unit, especially their party agents, and also the behavior of the ordinary voters at the polling unit. And that is why we have put in some safeguards and some mechanisms in relation to the polling units. What we are saying is that we are going to have a two-tier system at the polling unit, an inner cordon and an outer cordon. And the security agencies will assist in moving people into the inner cordon in batches. And before they move in, one, anybody who does not have a face mask should not even approach the polling units, because we are going to politely turn the person away. Secondly, we are going to make sure that we provide hand sanitizers for our presiding officers and assistant presiding officers, and also for the voters who are going to come to the polling unit. We're also going to make sure that we use methylated spirit to clean up our smart card readers in order to protect the health and the safety of the voters who come to the polling units.
All right.
And
Sorry to interject, but we're time constrained. So I wanted us to look a little at the by-elections that you're putting out for adoption against the backdrop of the Supreme Court ruling that vote belongs to the party. My question is, what will it take to successfully implement this system in Nigeria?
Well, the Electoral Management Body is not does not have legislative powers. The only thing we can do is to look at the situation, look at the Supreme Court judgments, and also collect the facts and the data and forward to the lawmaking authority and suggest. So I believe that what we are saying is that, for instance, as of today, we have 10 by-elections, 5 senatorial by-elections, and 5 state constituency assembly by-elections. What we are saying is that in 90% of all these elections that we have conducted, the party that was in power all was returned. It's only in 10% that we had a shift. So we are saying, is it possible for the Nigerian people to see, since the Supreme Court said votes belongs to the party, for the party that won before to make a replacement, or for the National Assembly to say, look, we cannot be conducting by elections almost every month. Let all the by-elections be harvested, and then we conduct by-elections maybe twice in a four-year electoral cycle. And so we are going to make some of these recommendations, and it's left for the National Assembly as the lawmaking institution to take it from there.
Thank you very much for joining us on the news.
Thank you so much.